1979, the 72nd session of the Arkansas General Assembly passed Act 106, an act to establish a state program for serving the needs of gifted and talented children. With this act, Arkansas launched into a decades-long fight for high-quality gifted education, a fight characterized not by a single individual, but by the strength and advocacy of innumerable parents, teachers, administrators, governors, and students from across the state. It is their continual leadership that has left Arkansas with hundreds of essential programs and services necessary to fill the social and educational needs of its gifted students.
So GT specifically stands for gifted and talented. So gifted education is for kids who are academically strong and able.
According to the Arkansas Department of Education, GT students are those of high potential or ability whose learning characteristics and educational needs require qualitatively differentiated educational experiences and/or services. In many cases, this is represented by those students performing in the top 5 to 10% in a variety of creative and academic areas.
You take the whole population, and you're going to have kids who are academically able. They learn fast. For education, to recognize that is key.
These gifted students are oftentimes not challenged by the average curriculum, and thus need an enriched or accelerated curriculum adapted to their needs to maximize their potential. By the late 70s, gifted and talented education was on the rise. As the United States strove to keep its students outperforming the rest of the world, especially those communist nations during the Cold War, a renewed interest in programs created for advanced students swept across the nation. In Arkansas, the leading advocate for gifted education was parent and private citizen Martha Ann Jones.
Certainly Martha Ann Jones Norton is considered to be the person who really started the ball rolling. She was a private citizen and parent.
They almost had like a strike force who would target specific places where decisions were made, because that's the key. They brought in a couple of powerful legislators, a couple of powerful superintendents, and they got a very small group of people to make their first efforts.
Advocating from a more political standpoint were Jones' longtime friends and then newly elected Governor and First Lady Bill and Hillary Clinton.
Governor Clinton and First Lady Hillary were both very involved in every policy decision. I don't think these things would have happened without support.
With the governor's support behind her, as well as a group of passionate parents and educators, Jones took the fight to the state legislature, working closely with state senators and representatives, such as Representative Jody Mahoney of El Dorado, in order to develop and pass a platform for gifted education. The work of Martha Ann Jones, Representative Mahoney, Governor and Mrs. Clinton, as well as the other early advocates for Arkansas GT, was finally manifested in 1979 with the passage of Act 106. This act established the Department of Education's Office of Gifted and Talented and created a mandate which required GT programs in every school district across the state. Act 106 was a conquest for Jones, as it was the first requirement by the Arkansas state government for the accommodation of the needs of gifted children. The fire behind gifted education did not fade as Arkansas progressed into the 1980s. Governor Clinton's educational platform continued to support GT education, and Martha Ann Jones' group of determined advocates continued to fight for the passage of a comprehensive legislative plan. Through this shared continued advocacy, many further gifted education bills were put into law during the early 80s. Highlights included Act 3, which set up the Arkansas Governor's School 6-week summer program and AGIS, or Academic Enrichment for Gifted and Summer GT programs. Act 56, which gave the Governor's Advisory Council on GT Education the ability to award prizes to the state's best GT programs. And perhaps most importantly, Act 34, which became law in 1983 and provided funding from the State Education Department. Arkansas gifted education now had the three components it needed to be successful.
There are a couple of things I think that help to make our programs good. One is that we have legislation that requires gifted services in schools. Second is that we have funding to help back that up. And then we have oversight from the State Department.
With these three components in place, gifted education in the state was able to prosper, and Arkansas became known nationally for its exemplary programs, especially Aegis and Governor's School.
Aegis programs were probably was the best thing the state ever did by offering enrichment classes, experiences during the summer. They hit at exactly what we're supposed to be doing, providing opportunities to children at no cost to them. It was the most phenomenal thing we've ever done.
Aegis gave many gifted children the educational and social advancement that the regular curriculum lacked, by providing them with a chance to interact with their fellow gifted children in an educational setting that went further than public school ever could.
Arkansas Governor's School is one of the oldest governor's school programs in the country. It is the best primo enrichment experience for gifted and talented students, and 400 students every summer come together between their junior and senior years and get to really focus on their social and emotional needs as gifted students. It's a great experience for them prior to going to college. It's one of the best programs that I know of.
The first governor's school was created in North Carolina in 1963 and served as a model for Arkansas's governor's school, created in 1980, making Arkansas only the fifth state to institute such a program. Today, 23 other states have governor's school programs, but many view Arkansas governor's school as one of the best in the nation. Over 20,000 Arkansan students have participated in the successful summer program since 1980.
The Governor's School, as I said, was really sort of one of the crowning achievements of Clinton's first term.
Besides being on the cutting edge of programs for students, Arkansas also provided some of the best teacher training programs for gifted education in the country. Due to the mandate for gifted programs in Arkansas, teachers needed specialized training and licensure to be equipped to teach gifted students. Training on a postgraduate level provided many burgeoning GT programs with the experienced teachers and coordinators needed to bring them to fruition. As I interviewed educators, coordinators, and advocates who have been involved in Arkansas GT for the past 35 years, one common theme became apparent. Gifted education is not defined by any one leader or single piece of legislation. Rather, it is defined by the many people who devoted their lives to filling the needs of Arkansas's gifted student population. Be it parent or teacher, advocate or legislator, school board member or governor, it is the work of countless leaders that has allowed Arkansas GT to prosper and have a lasting impact on the lives of thousands of gifted students. The conversation for gifted education in Arkansas may have been started by the vision of Martha Ann Jones, Representative Jody Mahoney, and the leadership from Governor Bill and Hillary Clinton. But legacy of Arkansas GT lives on every day in the continued leadership of the thousands of Arkansas teachers, administrators, and legislators who strive to meet the needs of every single child in Arkansas, especially those identified or not yet identified as gifted. More importantly, the real legacy of the Arkansas Gifted and Talented Program will be the ongoing impact made by the contributions of the thousands of students who directly or indirectly benefited from it. There is perhaps no way to truly measure the significance of the GT programs in Arkansas, but the legacy lives on in every student whose needs were met, whose ideas were challenged, and who was motivated to be the best they could possibly be.